Okay? And now we move forward from here. We are all talking about MBBS abroad. These are the things that you must understand completely. There are seven aspects which if you understand very clearly, I'm damn sure that you will be able to, you know, take a decision whether MBBS abroad is worth or not. And if yes, then not everything is good in MBBS abroad. Then how do I select? Where should I go? What is good for my career? You know, the main point is last. If you can change your perspective to only MBBS to PG, it will make much more sense. If you take a decision only for MBBS, it might be a troublesome area. Okay? So if you go through Asia, Europe, and these are your complete choices, where generally more than 30,000 Indian students are studying in these countries. Okay? You can also go to one of these countries in case either you are not come on merit of for the government medical colleges, or you are not been to, you know, through the, you don't have the money to pay to the private colleges. So you just need to be sure about it, that you have prepared for the abroad in case these two things are not clear. Okay, so we are talking now about Asia. Okay, in Asia, China is one of the most prominent country right now where Indian students are going. Okay, since many years now, as there are 8,000 students already there in 45 MCI approved universities. Fortunately for 2017, there are new 200 Chinese universities which have been, you know, approved. So you can definitely get the advantage of getting admissions much more easier compared to 2016 now. Choose A-graded university. That will help you a lot because of the infrastructure will be much better. The quality of education, the English speaking capabilities of the professors, everything will be much better. Okay. The advantage of China, I think I'll show you this. Advantage of China is mainly because of the large population leading to large patients flow and huge experience to study MBBS in a big infrastructure arena. The admission eligibility has been changing constantly. As I told you, in 2017, it's going to be much more easier to get an admission. These are other countries' advantages and disadvantages, which you can definitely see it for yourself. As you can see, the budgets of different colleges, different countries, you know, you should have different budgets for each of them, each one having the advantages and disadvantages. As you can read it on your screen, a lot of people make a mistake of going to Philippines, where you must understand the disadvantages very clearly. The NMET exam, actually the admission is only for BS initially. Okay, though the agents, etc., they tell you wrongly that, you know, it's for MBBS, it is only for Bachelor of Science. And after that, the government of Philippines takes NMAT exam. Not every examination not every student who passed the examination will be allowed to get it through MD, but it is a basic requirement to pass through. Only 40% of the students actually get the MD seats even after passing NMAT. So actually, 70% of the students who went to Philippines are in trouble right now. Okay? There are few good quality colleges wherein the passing ratio of NMAT is much higher, and then they have their own MD seats, and then they can transfer themselves to MD and complete the course. The advantages are there, but disadvantages are many. As you can see, the people with a lower budget, they choose Kyrgyzstan. People with a higher budget looking for higher quality education. And remember that China will ask for good percentages as well. PCB percentages should be high for good colleges. Otherwise, you will get into, you know, trouble by selecting C-grade universities. I just hope that basically you have understood the options of Asia very clearly. We will be sending you a recorded version of this conversation over email to each individual students without any problem. Okay, you will get, so that you can write down, jot down the points if you wish to, but you will get at your leisure, you will be able to hear and see the entire presentation on the email. We will send it to you. Very soon you will send it to you. Okay. When you come to East Europe, again the advantages are there. The general advantages of going abroad remain over there. But there are again many disadvantages as well. Okay. So how do we select a country out of this? Now many people think about Poland, but Poland, just because it's a part of European Union. The other countries are in Europe, like Poland and Romania is a part of European Union. Other countries are a part of East Europe. Okay. So lot of students go Russia, Ukraine, Georgia, Belarus. So how do these people, you know, select? And why do they go there? Basically, it's a very cold area, okay? And it's a six-year course. Remember that you will have to come back to India, appear for MCI screening test, and then do your internship in India again. So more or less, it will take 7.5 years to do MBBS, and still PG is away. In China, you have one advantage of five-year course. Okay, many universities with five-year course without internship in China. So that is one major advantage that you have got. Okay, in Kyrgyzstan and all, you have five-year and six-year program, but 5 years are in the private colleges, which are very low quality. So basically, the only university in Kyrgyzstan which is worth going to, which is a very low-cost government university, is KSMU, Kyrgyzstan State Medical University. So otherwise, people are just being, you know, pushed into other universities. So when you come to Russia or Ukraine, I think we can go on and on for different countries when you, each one of you can have personal discussions with us later on, which country among these. But remember, it's a six-year course. There is no five-year course in East Europe. Everything is 6 years. In Georgia, some of the universities claim to be 5 years, but then ultimately all the students have to spend their 6 years. So there is nothing like 5 year course in East Europe. Okay. The cost factors for East Europe will be varying from 20 to 35, this range again. If you add all your expenses, this is the range by which you can actually complete your course. Yeah, I hope you understand now. When you think about your, I'm just going through it in a very quick manner so that you have the entire brief about all the options. Now, the third option, as far as MBBS abroad is concerned, Asia, Europe, and US. This is the most, most popular place for most of the students. The pathway to MD needs to be understood very clearly. There are always two tracks, okay, that is offered. As you can read it, if you have done 12th science, you can get into MBBS, 2 years in St. Lucia, pass one exam called step one, then 2 years of clinical rotation in USA. So 4 years in MD. It's called MD in USA. The MBBS is called MD in USA. And then from there, it is 4 years in PG. So program does not end here. Whatever money you spend here, you get it back here. So biggest advantage is there is no MCI screening test once you pass, come back to India. Or you can work in US. It's your choice. In all other countries like China, Europe, East Europe, all countries you'll have to appear for MCI screening test. The US is the only country wherein you don't have to appear for MCI screening test. Your MD level, PG level degree is directly acceptable in India, and the money which you spent on bachelor level, you get it back during your PG level. So it's one of the best option basically. However, the point is it is quite expensive, as much expensive as an Indian private college. So people who are looking for Indian private colleges and ready to spend 70 to 75 lakh rupees, this can be a better option for them. Those who are looking for India track, so coming back to India, then the costs come down because observership can be done, okay, instead of clinical rotation in US. So then you can come back to India, but that's not advisable. If you are looking for India track, it's better to do it from China or East Europe. So that is how it is worked out. This is, of course, the most preferred, most recommended program for all the children. What has been the past, you know, student trend? Where have the students have, you know, actually gone in the past over a period of years, last 10, 15 years? This has been the way, you know, as you can see it from the graph, the blue line is China. It went on increasing. By 2010, the number of students going to China and Russia was almost equal. But by 2014, it had suddenly dropped because the seats had come down. And now in 2017, we are expecting it to slowly slide going up now here. I hope you understand now. So East Europe and China has been competing, while number of students going to US has been very small but going constantly. This is more because of the expensive program that it offers. These are all low-cost programs. I hope this chart gives you a very clear picture about, you know, how the students have been, Indian students have been flying out for MBBS. Why, you know, MBBS became East Europe became popular? Because suddenly Chinese, you know, seats went down. Also, the seats were available, the applications were accepted right up to July every year. While Chinese good universities did not have their seats open up to a large, you know, up to more than May, June, everything was got over with. Russia was the first one to offer MCI approved education. Way back in 1996, people went there, okay? Almost 20 years. And Russia teaches Western medicine for last 300. Like China has started Western medicine like allopathy only in the last 50 years. Before that it had TCM, traditional Chinese medicine, just like our Ayurveda. So China still has lot of TCM colleges, but Western medicine is taught recently in the last 50 years. Russia has a huge experience in teaching medicine. So these were the reasons due to which people are continuing to grow to go to East Europe, in spite of being 6-year program and China being 5 years, still, you know, people prefer that. How do you choose a university? You know, you can see this just a small relevance, that comparison that we have given. It's not exact, but, you know, the top college of India, you can see, consider it as an A-grade university abroad. The Indian government colleges are like B-grade universities in terms of infrastructure, patients flow, library size, quality of education. This is how it is. Indian private colleges are at par with C-grade universities. So if you are going abroad, at least do not go to the C-graded universities. Go minimum B-graded. On our website, which is being upgraded, moksh16.com. Okay? You can definitely get the grades of the university as defined by WHO. Okay. To understand and select on the internet also, you will get a lot of grades. Right now, the website is not under maintenance. It will start off from Wednesday around 12th. You can expect it to restart because we are uploading a lot of new universities and, you know, a lot of more information, more guidance is available. So quality comparison is available within the different countries. As you can read it on your screen very clearly. You are in a position to block the seat the way you want in the places, in the university or in the country that you wish to. For 2017, already the season has started. A lot of people are blocking their seats already. So cost comparison is, you have to think about both the things. Do not only say the package price, you know, that's how the whole thing is being worked out in India. It's not only the price, but it's also the quality. So go also for the grade of the university, hospital affiliations, the experience in teaching, the number of years the university has been teaching, the internship rules, everything you need to take care. It's not only the total cost. As you can see, the cost of private college through entrance or matches with that of US, but otherwise everything else is very, very cost effective. I hope it's clear. I'm going to move into the next slide now to just explain you some things about MCI screening test. It's also called FMG, which is conducted by National Board of Examination. This is the main thing that you should understand as far as the FMG is concerned. Whenever you go abroad in countries like China, Russia, Ukraine, you have to give MCI screening test on your return back. And most of the people who are not prepared for this exam in a systematic, scientific manner, then you will not be able to pass through. If you can't pass, it means you are not in a position to practice in India. So if you go to a good quality institute, definitely it will help you to pass the FMG. Remember that FMG and NEET PG is almost the same. In fact, from 2017, the government has already mooted a proposal wherein a single exit exam will be taken by the government for all the students, whether from India or abroad. And this MCI screening test will not be there only for the people coming from foreign country. They want to filter, but they do not want to filter only foreign medical graduates. They also want to filter the Indian graduates. And the main thing that you must understand is there are vast 19 subjects that you need to learn during FMG. Okay? In case you just learn over there 6 years and don't come back, don't prepare for MCI during your studies there, that means you are in trouble. You cannot come back and, you know, appear for an examination which is based on all 19 subjects within 3 to 4 months of your arrival back in India. It's impossible to pass that exam. So we will always give you MCI screening test coaching, which keeps you in touch with MBBS program in India. And that program will be given online just in case you decide to go abroad. So if you go there without such coaching available, then there is a big problem. So please do not go for, there is a difference between agents and consultants. Do not go for admission agents. Go for a proper counseling consultants who can advise you, who can provide you, who can give you travel support, who can give you admission support, who can give you MCI screening test coaching, who can give you A to Z right up to the end, then only you can choose your consultant. Okay. How do you apply? It's a very system, simple system. The admissions are already opened. You can block the seats in any of the universities that you wish to, you know, go for. So first of all, you will have to actually understand which one suits you as per budget, as per your eligibility, as per your other many criteria such as grade of the university required and living conditions and weather conditions and lot of such things, because it's very cold area, East Europe, that may not suit everybody. In China, the cost may be slightly higher in A grade. But then, you know, so different criteria for different students, basically. Somebody is looking for only right up to PG, then the US is the best option for them. So you need to take up your call. Like, there are scholarships available right now for US, so people are already blocking their seats, as well as scholarship letters are being issued. So this is what we can do for you while you are preparing for Indian MBBS seat. A parallel backup can be created for, you know, for your child, if you're a parent, or for a student himself or herself. So we'll ensure that, you know, the whole journey for MBBS goes, the handholding is given for a smooth journey right up to the end. I hope you have read it through, and I'll just... You can think about, you know, always go for all total cost. Do not just go for your tuition fee cost. You always have to understand the local. For example, Georgia. Now, many people say only this $4,500 is the tuition fee, but they miss a point that the actual cost of living, including accommodation, is another $4,500. That's not true for China or Russia, but for Georgia specifically. So they miss that point and the student is in big trouble. So $4,500 is the tuition fee, but another $4,500 for the living, that becomes almost $9,000. I hope you understand now. So 6 years like that means almost $60,000 will go. That means almost 40 lakh rupees required by you. That's pretty expensive. So always include tuition fee, include accommodation, include living cost, include the initial cost, travel package, everything. Then you work out the package. Okay. Here we are. I think I have covered most of the points that I had to tell you. Now you can start asking me the questions over chat. And I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. See, basically, we are the consultants. We are not an agent. I don't know your name. Your name is not being flashed here, whoever asked me the question. Because we provide you the MCI screening test. As I told you, you go through the website, you will immediately be able to understand that what is the difference. Admission agent will not even have a proper website. Okay? They are just with a small office sitting across like sub-agents. And they send the documents to us. And we have to process everything, but in front they say that I am doing everything. So our fees, Miss N, our fees are very different from university to university, country to country. It's all mentioned on the website. I would advise you that first you understand the other part. Do not worry about our fees. We have a lot of scholarships from Moksh also. So it's a complicated thing to ask right now to get into the details in one shot, but I would advise you to get into the details of the program that interests you first, country that interests you. If you, Anushka, what if you want to do our PG in any other country other than US? See, if you read Constitution of MCI, the PG is acceptable in India. Clinical PG or medical PG is acceptable to in India, back by MCI, only and only if you have done it from an English speaking country, not otherwise. So suppose we recruit a lot of students for medical PG in Germany, okay? But that those students who opt for that program, they settle down in Germany, okay? They don't come back to India. But if those students who have been sent for MBBS or PG in US, they settle down in US, and that degree is also acceptable back in India. So at a later date, whenever they come back, they don't have any problem. But if you're doing it from Germany, then you definitely have a problem. You can't work as MD in India. Okay? So any other question? Anybody else? Yeah. So see.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Tell me.
Are you hearing me? Hello, sir.
Yeah, tell me, Mr. Mangal.
Hanji, sir. Hello, sir. I have decided for my son to study in abroad for MBBS.
Okay.
I want to have a deal of universities, English medium, within budget 15 to 20 lakhs, full package, no hidden charges. I also want to know the dates for applying, etc.
Yeah, I will tell you, I'll give you one number. I think those people who want to block the seat, they can contact over here directly.
Sir, will you email me all these things?
Yeah. We will email you. That's not a problem. I'm also giving you one number wherein you can get in touch with for the further communication. That will help you. Okay. This is the number.
Sir, 15 to 20 lakhs. My budget is 15 to 20 lakhs. And I want English medium university.
Yeah. I understand what you're saying. Only English medium universities are approved by MCI. Local language universities are not approved by MCI, first of all, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Is it possible within budget 15 to 20 lakhs?
It is definitely possible. It was there as a part of the presentation. Probably you missed it. There are many options within this budget. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
So, I have given you the number and we'll get back to you. You can get back to us. We'll be sending you the email and on email we'll be continuing. Mr. Nageshwarao, your question is... The student does not qualify for USMLE. Okay. I will just briefly answer you because we have one more webinar specifically for US. Okay. You can get every information on US program, Mr. Nageshwarao. But since you have asked me question right now, I'll just answer this particular question on US. If you go through a website, usmle.org. Okay, you will be in a position to see the results of USMLE 1 and 2 for the last 23 years. And you will observe that 96% of the students clear USMLE. Okay, so there are a lot of other things that you need to understand apart from that. So that we will take it up in the next. But you can definitely go through this particular website and check the passing ratios for the last 23 years for both of these exams. Remember, USMLE 2 is just a qualifying exam. USMLE 1 is a competitive exam for US. Okay. I hope that gives you a very clear picture. Kavan Sharma, for USA, there are various scholarship programs which will be the best for Indians. I think, Kavan, you need to at first understand the program and then talk of scholarships. I would request you to go through the US program first. Okay, the webinar on US, understand the whole challenges, etc. As Mr. Nagesh Rao was asking me about step 1 and step 2, those examinations will have to be understood before you can take a decision. Then talk about scholarships, okay? Which country is better for taking admissions? Mr. Abdul, it all depends on the quality of education, whether you're looking for MBBS or right up to PG, you're looking for budgets. All those things, once they are clear, then only we can talk about the country selection. Yeah, I can't read the name of the next question. Sir, I heard that Indian government is removing FMG exam for the students who are coming from abroad after completing MBBS. Yeah, that's true. And the government is introducing another exam called NEXT. Can you tell me? See, NEXT is for, it's just an exit exam for all the students. I already spoke about it. The expected exam will be for everybody. Whether you are from a foreign country or whether you are from India. Even if those students who are passing from private colleges, will have to appear for this exam. That is the mooted proposal right now. So let us hope that it works. Okay. Mr. Anil Kumar Singhadi, how about Ukrainian university? Any entrance test? No, there are no entrance tests over here in Ukraine. Before selecting Ukraine, you should be more careful because of the zones of war zones are available in Ukraine. So you can call us for further guidance on Ukraine. Okay. Don't choose, in short, don't choose eastern part. Eastern part is on war zone. If you are hell-bent to go to Ukraine, then choose on the western or southern part of Ukraine. Okay. Anushka, you are asking for PG from US, Russia, PG from all the people who do PG from Russia. They are all doing it for Middle East. They all go to Middle East, Dubai, Qatar and all those places. All the Indian students who have passed out, they are all going there. They cannot work as MD in India, remember. What is the criteria for taking loan for MBBS in USA? That's a very different question. We'll take it up. Mr. Abdul, only 20 to 30 lakh rupees of loan, education loan is possible by the Indian banks. You must have around 40 lakh rupees of budget of your own, 40 to 50 lakhs, then only you can get the loan. Okay. Yeah, Miss Babita, is it possible to switch off your webcam? Because it's going to flash on everybody's screen right now if you, and it will disturb on the connectivity. Miss Babita? Yeah. I hope, Mr. Vishal, you are able to hear me. Anushka, you can come back to India. It's not about not coming back to India. It's all about whether coming back to India, will you be able to work as MBBS or MD? Because you studied PG, correct? You are talking about PG, doing PG in Russia. So if you do that PG in Russia, it will not be helpful for you to be utilized as a degree because MCI will not recognize it. You can come back, there is no problem. But what is the point in doing PG when you can't use that degree over here? One more
question. From which country can we do PG?
So PG can be done by in US. That I told you, English speaking countries are all accepted by MCI for PG.
I want to know that if after doing MBBS from China, can a child practice there?
See, the chance, you have to give one more exam over there for registration purpose. Okay. Remember that.
Okay.
So,
if it's you like MCI exam only.
No. The competition is not, it's not a competitive exam. Remember that. Okay. Generally, okay. Anyone who wants to pass off that, give the exam, who has studied will pass the exam. That's not a problem. Okay. It's not.
We have heard that only for one or two years they teach in English and afterwards they start teaching in Chinese language and senior students usually teach the junior student. Is it true in China?
No. This is true in C grade universities. If you opt for 2 lakh rupees of fee structure, this is what is going to happen.
Like this China Medical University, Tianjin University, these are A grade universities.
China Medical is expensive. It's a very, very good university. In fact, it has one of the best of the hospitals available in China. One of the largest hospitals.
What is the cost there?
That would be around 4 lakh plus around 75,000 rupees for the hostel and all. So around 5 lakh rupees is the fees per year with hostel. And another 8,000 to 10,000 rupees for your living cost, you know, per month. So around 36 lakh rupees will be required for A grade universities in China. If you go to B grade, it will be like 25. If you go to C grade, it will be like 18 lakhs, you know. So it all depends which exactly are you looking.
Now, if we are ready to spend around 45, 50, so we can get good medical A grade universities in China.
Easily. In fact, you don't need to go to China. If you have 50 lakh of budget, you should be going for US, not for China. You can take an additional loan in US for 20 lakh rupees and then you can complete your entire course right up to PG.
Okay.
See, the value of MBBS in the next 6 years will not be as much as what you are seeing now. People have already started going to
So
PG.
fit for PG. So PG we'll have to go to some English speaking country only, or we'll have to come back to India.
You'll have to come back to India because
That's
PG
the only
is,
way.
yeah, because if you've done MBBS somewhere else, then passing USMLE step one will be very difficult for you. So you have to come back to India, pass MCI screening test, pass NEET PG or whatever is the system after 6 years to get a PG seat. That's going to be not, that's even worse. Passing a step one is easier than to pass a get a seat through NEET PG actually. So right from the beginning, if you choose the right place, then it will make much better sense because US needs basic requirement to become a physician, to act like a physician, practice as a physician is PG. It's not MBBS. In India, you can practice after MBBS, but over there you
MBBS.
can't. Yeah. So the best part is you get into the system where you are already aiming for PG, you know.
So how do the children who study MBBS from China, are they comfortable working here? Do the hospitals
Yeah. Thousands of students have become doctors and they have played, you know, they passed MCI screening test. Lot of people are stuck because they did not study MCI screening test coaching. They did not take at the time of when they are learning there. They find it difficult to pass here. So it's all kind of people are available right now in India. Those who are happy, those who are working in government hospitals, private hospitals, those who have passed medical PG also in India, and those who are not even able to pass MCI screening test. And they are repenting that they should have studied for prepared for it earlier. So it all depends on the student also, you know. Okay. One more question that I have is if MBBS is from India, how tough is it to do PG in US? For people who are doing MBBS in India from government colleges, USMLE is not tough at all to pass out. Lots and lots of students pass. In a batch of 60 or 80, almost 20 people are going to US. Except for one problem, now in 2016, that problem has started. It's called NORI certificate. So if you are from a government college, you cannot do PG from USA. You can just type NORI certificate. Regulation by Government of India on Google, you will understand the whole stuff. I'm not getting much into the detail, but now doing PG in USA has become difficult if you have done PG MBBS in India, especially from a government college. If you have done it from a private college, then the problem is you will not be able to crack step one because your merit already, you know, says that you are not as good as the government college students. Mr. Mangal Sen, sir, in Russia for MBBS, is it mandatory to learn Russian? Yeah, it is mandatory to learn Russian in Russia, Chinese in China, because you will be interacting with the patients in their local language. So unless you learn it, you won't be able to, you know, take it forward. Okay, so don't worry about language. Language is a very basic level of language that you need to learn. Conversational language is what they teach you. Mr. Nageshwar Rao, about Australia and England. In England, it's a very difficult thing to go through PLAB. There is another body called PLAB. There are exams and exams and exams. So, and in Australia, there are two exams after MBBS, which is AMC and MCI. There are two exams that we need to give for Australia. So, but to do MBBS in Australia is exorbitantly expensive. It will touch almost 2 crores. Including living costs. Mr. Abdul, MBBS in Germany you cannot do actually. Okay, it's been, lot of people are being fooled. You be very, very, very clear on this aspect. In Germany, the courses are conducted only in German language. In order to get into MBBS, first of all, you will have to complete your Bachelor of Science within Germany. That itself will take 4 years. And after that, you can enter into the actual medical course. So that would take further 3 years, and then after that you have to do PG. That would take further 4 years. So 4 plus 3 plus 4, almost 11 years if everything goes well with you. So don't get bogged down by, you know, interested into it because people say study free in Germany. It doesn't work like that. lot of expenses are there in terms of learning the language, the living cost for 11 years. It's huge. Okay. So I think I have replied most of the question except for last Mr. Sudarshan. Is it compulsory? Yes, I already answered you. It is compulsory to learn Chinese language up to HSK4. A normal Chinese student will learn up to 9 level. You are just going to learn it up to 4. Many Indian students find it so easy after 4 that they complete it up to 6. Then they become eligible for doing PG in medicine in China itself, and then they can work over there itself. Yeah, Nori is applicable only if Nori is not applicable if you are from a private college. Basically, government does not want to sign the Nori certificate if they have funded your MBBS studies. That's the logic. Okay, they invested in you, they gave you subsidy, you became MBBS from a government college, now you want to run away to US. So they are not going to allow you to do that. This is 2016 May regulation. Okay. Yeah, thank you, Abdul. I think you understood my about Germany. Could you give the most convenient way to do MBBS from Russia? Yeah, Rishabh, we are situated in Mumbai, but we have lots of different ways to approach all the students who communicate back to us. So be in touch with us. There are, in Russia, always choose Moscow if possible. That's the first thing that I can say. Your 90% problem will be over if you choose the capital city in Russia. Okay? That's all I can tell you right now. Rest, we will communicate with each other more on this and help you to select the university and get it applied. Okay? What about study in US and Canada have both the same system. So you can, everything that I told you about US, or you can also attend the next webinar on US. Okay? That also will help you. Yeah, thanks a lot. I gathered from the presentation, Eastern Europe, it will take totally 7.5 years, 6 for the course, followed by MCA screening test, and then one year of internship here. That's right. I can't read your name, but I think you are right. It's 7 years, not 7.5 years. Okay. Yeah, Rishabh, Moscow would be the best option for you to do it. I think I have completed most of the people questions. Anybody else? I'll take one last question, and then we can, of course, we will send the, those who have registered the email ID, we will send the recorded version of the entire thing. Okay. The US webinar is, I think, at 7 o'clock today, but somebody will give you a call. Somebody will give you a call. Okay. Somebody will give you a call and I'll ask you to send you a link for participating in the US webinar if you're interested. What about MBBS in Nepal? It's a private college. You have to pay first 3 years fees at a time. Around 30 lakh rupees you need to in the first year itself to pay, because they are not sure whether the students will survive here or not, because the quality of education is very low. The patients flow is very low. The, you know, they are selling it on the basis of Indian professors and Indian food and no visa required. So it's not based on the quality of education. It's more to do with the, you know, comfort of the parents and students who send to Nepal. So you can select Nepal only if you are looking for ease of studies. Sir, how is Anushka? Yeah, see, Russia, you have one problem, okay, Anushka? Many of the B-graded or C-graded universities will have 3 years of teaching in Russian and 3 years in English and then 3 years in Russian, okay? Many better quality will have 4 years in English and then 2 years in Russian, okay? But the best ones would have 4.5 years in English, 6 months in Russian, and last year internship is always naturally in Russian because patients will speak only Russian. So you have larger time to learn Russian language. Okay. So Russia is good that way. But remember, it's a 6 year option with a cold region. Maximum number of students currently are in Russia from India. Okay. Please send us the webinar. Okay, Mr. Nagar, I'll be sending you the US webinar details. 1 year internship, Mr. Abdul. Wherever you go out, it's going to be 1 year internship, and they are paid internship in the sense that you will have to pay, not they will not pay. Mr. Rushabh, depends, the cost will depend again on the grade of the universities, okay? It'll start from 15 lakhs to right up to 35 lakhs, so it depends on that. Miss N, I think your question is again related to US, but I'd request you to just join us in US webinar. Okay, generally it takes around 9 years to complete right up to PG, almost equivalent to India. Okay, and in Russia the total time will be around 7 years. Yeah, Sanjay. Yeah, Mr. Sanjay, you are asking me something.
China University.
Huh?
Sir, why language at China University?
China? I can't hear you actually, Sanjay. Anyway, so Russia would be a 6 years course plus 1 year back when you come back. So it's going to be 7 years for you to become a doctor. Yeah, that's right, Rishabh. You will need to do 1 year internship back in once you're back in India. That's correct. So if MBBS, Anushka, if MBBS is from Russia, then what are the possible options for PG? Possible option for PG is from Russia only, because remember that you have already learned a language. Second option is for medical PG in Germany. I would advise you to go through our website. There is a separate given moksh16.com. It is not running right now. It is under maintenance, but it will start off from Tuesday. Over there, medical PG in Germany is there. That is an option. Lot of students from Russia are opting for Germany. We place them in Germany. They start learning German language from fourth year onwards. But that is possible only if you are in Moscow, remember. Now, other countries do not have German language programs as widely available. Okay. So medical PG in Germany is definitely available for the students who are studying from Russia. The medical PG in Germany is one of the best programs that could be done. Okay. And your life is set if you do that, actually. It's a fantastic course and it doesn't cost you. Doesn't cost you much. Okay. Mr. Patel, your question. Yeah, we will be sending you the link for the webinar for the US. Recording of this webinar and presentation or mail IDs or brush up your today's. Definitely we'll be sending you, just give us some time and we'll be sending you the web. I think I'll keep a hang on this complete discussion. I hope this has helped all of you to have a basic glance into an option which is available for you. Please treat this as a plan B. What we suggest is create this plan B before the real plan A comes into the effect, where you are, when you are running from pillar to post for the admission. This year there will not be running around. There is no need to go to any agent for the private colleges. It's highly simplified system this year. Only one single exam. Everything is easy. Just create a backup and all of you are through with it. Either you are in India or abroad, one of them, you don't waste your year just because you did not take action on the right time. Okay. So I wish you all the best, and we will see you again on US for those who are interested to do that. Okay. Thank you. Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. I'll be sending you the recording, Abdul, for everybody. So don't worry. Okay. Thank you. Thanks, Anushka. Bye-bye.